Okay, then for today's video, we're going to take a look at finding the circumference of a circle. So when we want to find the circumference of a circle, we want to use our formula, which is pi multiplied by the diameter. So our formula would look like this. The circumference is equal to pi multiplied by the diameter of the circle. And we can rearrange this, because if I divide both sides of this equation by the diameter, I'd actually get pi is equal to the circumference divided by the diameter. And that's exactly what pi is. It's the ratio between the circumference of a circle and its diameter. So pi to two decimal places being 3.14. We know that the circumference of a circle is always going to be 3.14 times bigger than its diameter. So for this first question, it says give our answer in the terms of pi. So what I'm going to do is substitute. The circumference is going to be equal to pi multiplied by the diameter, which in this case is 10. So I can rewrite this that the circumference is equal to 10 times pi, which I can just write as 10 pi. And we can stop there, because it said it wanted the answer in terms of pi. So for my answer, I've got to make sure that I include the correct units. So that would be 10 pi. And because we're dealing with centimetres, we'd have centimetres in our answer. Okay, for our next question, we've got to find the circumference again. And just like before, we've got to give our answer in terms of pi. So we know that circumference is equal to pi multiplied by the diameter. But this question's a little different. We've got to be really careful on this one. We're given, for this particular question, the radius. We know that the radius is equal to 7. For our formula for the circumference, we need the diameter. So to get the diameter, all we have to do is double it. So if our radius is 7, that means our diameter would be 14. So we can take that back over to the original equation. The circumference is going to be equal to pi multiplied by the diameter, which is 14. So our circumference is just 14 pi. So leaving that in terms of pi for our answer, our final answer would be 14 pi, and then using the correct units, this time we'd have meters. Okay, for this next question, we've got to find the circumference of the circle, but we've got to give our answer to two decimal places this time. So again, we know our formula is that for the circumference is just going to be pi multiplied by the diameter. So for this particular question, the circumference is just going to be pi multiplied by 21, as that's our diameter. So now if we type that into our calculator, we do pi multiplied by 21, we get 65.9734 and then carries on. So our answer needs to be to two decimal places, so that's enough to round. So we have the circumference is equal to 65.9 and then it will remain as a 7, as the next number along as a 3. So our answer to this question would be 65.97. Looking back at the units, it would be centimetres. And that would be the answer to that one. Okay, we've got to find the circumference again. Again, leaving our answer to two decimal places. So as always, writing our formula, we know the circumference is pi times the diameter. So that's what I need to substitute in. I need the diameter. If we look at the question, we're actually given the radius. The radius is 31.5. So to find the diameter, all I have to do is double it. So if I times 31.5 by 2, I'd actually get 63. So to substitute into this formula, the circumference is going to be equal to pi multiplied by 63 this time. So if we do that on the calculator, if we do pi multiplied by 63, we get 197.9203 and carries on. So then for my final answer, all I have to do is round to two decimal places. So that would be 197.9. And then the 2 would stay as a 2, as the next number along is a 0. So our final answer would be 197.92. Then looking back at the question, our units would be centimetres. Okay, for this next question, we're given the circumference of a circle is 44 pi meters. We need to find the length of the radius. We know that the circumference of a circle is pi multiplied by the diameter. But in this question, we're told what the circumference is. We know that the circumference is 44 pi. So if we know that the circumference is equal to pi times the diameter, then that means that this 44 pi must also be pi multiplied by the diameter. So if we've got 44 times pi is the same as pi times the diameter, if we divide both these sides by pi, we'd have 44 pi divided by pi gives us 44, and then pi multiplied by the diameter, then divided by pi would just be the diameter. So if we know the diameter of this circle is 44, Then all we have to do to find the radius is half it. So half of 44 would be 22. So the answer to this question would simply be 22. Then looking back at the original question, the circumference was given in meters, so the radius would be 22 meters. And for our final question today, we've got the circumference of a circle is 93 centimeters. We need to find the length of the radius, giving our answer to two decimal places. So just like all the other questions, we use our original formula. The circumference of a circle is pi multiplied by the diameter. However, we're given what the circumference is. We know that the circumference is 93 centimeters, so that must also be equal to pi multiplied by the diameter. So even though we want the radius, we're going to find out what the diameter is first, and we can do that by simply dividing the right-hand side by pi. Because we've done that to the right-hand side, we've also got to do that to the left to keep it equivalent. So on the right-hand side first, if I do pi times the diameter, which then I divide by pi, that's just going to give me the diameter, so I'm going to write that here, is equal to, and then I've got 93 divided by pi. So if we do that on our calculators, 93 divided by pi would give us 29.6028. And then because we've got the diameter, we want to figure out the radius. All I'm going to do now is divide that by 2. So if I divide that number by 2 and give our answer to two decimal places, I end up with 14.80. So our final answer to this question would be 14.80. Then looking back at the question, the circumference was given in centimetres, so this would be centimetres also. And that's the final answer to this question. So that's it for today's video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are at all any topics you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments. And I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.